Healthcare professionals have raised the alarm about the risks of lowering quarantine restrictions amid the surging COVID-19 cases. Joining us now is infectious diseases expert, Dr. Benjamin Ko. Good morning, sir, and thank you for joining us on the program again.
Magandang umaga po, Christian, and good morning, everyone.
Okay, since last year, I've been monitoring the numbers or the way the Philippine government, specifically the Department of Health, has been trying to handle this COVID-19 pandemic. We're now under an MECQ. Based on the numbers, was this a good idea to actually shift to the less stringent MECQ at this stage?
Well, that's an excellent question. And I think even within our own our circles, we argue whether it would be a good shift to MECQ or extend the ECQ. The problem you get with that is trying to balance both the economy and healthcare. So something has got to give eventually, and it's a very difficult balance because there really is no playbook for the pandemic, and individual countries also experience individual problems. On the question on whether it's timely to shift back to MECQ, well, I guess the basis for that was because we're seeing better reproduction numbers, which means that it's lower now. It would have been good, and this is a personal thought, it would have been good to extend it a little further, considering that the numbers are plateauing within 9,000 to 10,000 nationally. And it took us quite some time before we were able to bring down the cases in August of 2020. So it would have been good. It would have been ideal. The question is, would the economy be able to take it? Because people will also die of hunger.
The other question is, have we done enough actually during those 2 weeks of ECQ to be able to prepare us much better under an MECQ and to be able to address the current surge that we're seeing now?
Yeah, the current surge is actually very different from the surge we saw last August. You know, this is a surge wherein we are almost triple the cases we see in August of last year. And that means you would have to triple the number of hospitals also. The triple the amount of ICUs, triple the amount of healthcare systems that would be able to provide adequate health capacity to all. So are we more prepared? Let's call a spade a spade. The answer is no. No, we're really actually not more prepared. And that's why the rapid trajectory, the rapid incline has overwhelmed the healthcare system very rapidly as well. I mean, let's go to facts. In the first surge of 2020, part of the program was not to include home care. We did not call for people to put oximeters in the house. You know, now you see people in the first surge, people were grappling at and grasping for masks, PPEs. Now they're grasping for oxygen, pulse oximeters, and other peripheral needs. So we see how bad it is currently compared to last year.
Was it actually fair to say that nobody expected such numbers that like the ones that we're seeing now?
No, because it was expected.
Common narrative coming from the government, right? They're saying nobody expected this much numbers.
I guess, you know, if you follow the data, and I don't think that the health agency is just a tallying agency. You know, if you follow the data, you will actually see that there was already an incline from the end of February of this year. I mean, I do a personal follow-up on this daily. I've been doing it for over a year. And if you follow OCTA Research data group, the group's data, you will notice that they've been sounding the alarm even as early as March. Had we acted earlier, before the lockdown, the ECQ, during the Holy Week, we probably would not reach these numbers. Had we acted on this at least about 2 to 3 weeks earlier.
about the importance of leadership and communication, this is a recurring issue that we have been raising since last year. The fact that you have the IATF, but on top of the IATF, you have President Duterte, and every week, the public is waiting for him to address the nation. And to be frank about it, it was very, very disappointing to a lot of Filipinos hearing what he said a few days back when people were waiting for what was the plan regarding the current surge that we're seeing now. Do you see any problem as far as leadership is concerned, to be frank about it, in this government's pandemic response?
Let's just say that in every leadership, there should be a recognition of gaps and opportunities. No, the only way we can address issues is we realize the gaps so that we can rise from those gaps by instituting opportunities. That to me is the most important thing. Second is, if we are not able to do that and you allow other people to run the show, I guess personally I would probably pay more attention to empathy and compassion as well. If there is nothing left to give, then at least let us provide empathy and compassion to people in a crisis. They look up to a leader and they would expect a little compassion and a little empathy, particularly those that are suffering in the situation. And it leaves a bad taste in the mouth when people spin the story a different way. And when I say spin the story in a different way, it looked more like to just show proof of life, you know, show somebody who is relaxing in a more relaxed state does not sit well with the majority of the Filipinos.
As a health worker, how did you feel about that?
Frustrated. Siyempre kasi sana may kaakibat kami. Kasi pagod na din po, no? It's not that we're complaining, it's that we're looking for more help from people on the top. Of course, we don't expect them to be on the ground together with us, but to support us in a more decent way.
Okay. Dr. Benjamin Ko, thank you very much for joining us this morning. Stay safe, sir.
Thank you.